warm-up. Not with a warm-up like that. His shoulders have been up. He hasn't been bending his knees.
The last U.S. man to win the men's gold medal at the Olympics, Brian Boitano, 1988.
Our next skater.
Final instructions from his coach. Every U.S. man who has competed at the Olympics as the reigning world champion has won. Dick Button, Hayes Jenkins, David Jenkins, and Scott Hamilton. But no reigning world champion has won the Olympics since Scott did it in 1984. Evan Lysacek in second place, narrowly, after the short program.
To open this routine. The next jump, the most difficult in this program. He's retooled it this year. It's his triple axle. Does not have a quad. He needs to hit this beautifully.
Ha! And he did.
He did.
Here, get his legs recharged, because the next four elements in this program are his Olympics, and they're all in the bonus where he gets a 10% bump. Triple of Lutz. Thank you. These footwork sequences are where Evan needs to really pull as many points as possible to challenge Pashenko.
Check well, the skate of his life.
That was not an easy performance for him. He had to think through every moment, and he relied on all that training. He did it. He skated a clean performance. Wow.
Representing the United States of America, Evan Lysacek.
The hardest working, best conditioned athlete in this competition, and he delivered the goods.
He got stronger at the end as it went on. His family here, they're thrilled. His older sister, Laura, he could never beat her in anything. Not in soccer, not in baseball, not in anything. He found his calling, though.
And to skate like that after the warm-up he had. That was really, really something. I mean, that is incredible power.
I think he's about 5 inches taller now than he was when he got on the ice.
No kidding. And he had such a free short program. And this one, he worked.
It did. You could sense the tension. You could sense him working each thing and hoping for the best. And he needed to be a quality skate. There's a couple little things that he hung on to and a couple little things he may not have gotten the height. But you got to look at this. This is a triple axel double toe in the bonus, okay? A quad is worth 9.8. This is worth 9.5.
Forever coaching, counting.
Every
never
spin,
giving up.
Every rotation, every edge in this program. He needed to milk everything he could out of it to give his best effort against a very strong Yevgeny Pashenko.
And truly the most difficult place to skate.
Thank you, Vera.
Skating first, not knowing,
right,
not being able to judge your other competitors, just having to go out there and do it without any time to think or any time to breathe.
But this is it. For Evan, no would-haves, could-haves, or should-haves. Whatever comes out of this Olympic Games is what was meant to be. He's just got to be happy with that, and
absolutely
two solid routines, short and long.
Well, Frank Carroll said after the short program, when Evan was overcome with tears, he wanted to say, stop it, stop it. He said, if he cries tonight and he wins, I'll let him cry for a long time. With his choreographer, Lori Nichol, and his coach, Frank Carroll, here are the scores. You see what he needs.
He has earned 167.37 points.
That's the best by far ever free skate. And his total, 257.67, is a personal best.
Evan Lysacek,
rising to the Olympic moment.
Component scores were really high, and he put up a big number technically. Pashenko's going to have to skate really well. Really well.
How about that? If he skates last after Lysacek was leading off.
Nobunari Oda.